Hello friends, are you ready for some freakily, spookily, paranormal videos? I am. Today, we are checking out a channel called Nuke's Top 5. You probably know it. I know you do. Without further ado, let's check it out. See what it got in store for us today.
A house without history. A family living in Kansas City, Missouri are away from home one night when their Nest security camera captures something truly bizarre. A shadow-like figure about the height of a child can be seen moving from the upstairs bedroom.
Oh.
The figure doesn't appear to walk or run, but rather...
Look how fast it is, man. Look how fast and translucent it is. Holy air fryer, man.
Oh. A shadow-like figure about the height of a child can be seen moving from the upstairs bedroom.
That's creepy, man.
The figure doesn't appear to walk or run, but rather float at a high speed before it just disappears into thin air.
Superhuman speed!
A small childlike voice can be heard calling out, "Help!"
Oh! What the
F, man? The family has never
experienced
anything paranormal before, so they have no idea just what this could be. The house was only built 15 years ago, and they've searched online, but they can't find any strange history about the house or land.
That's even weirder.
Just what is this?
I don't know.
Let me
know
what
you think. It's Casper, the friendly ghost.
We need scary videos.
He needs help.
So if you see anything that you think would be perfect for the top five, send it to us at nukestop5@gmail.com. The uninvited guest. A family on Rote Island in Indonesia are gathered to celebrate a birthday. When one of the guests captures something truly chilling on camera.
What? Did you see it?
A strange uninvited guest can be seen looking into the window, watching
the
family the
F,
as they
man.
Celebrate. Now, without a source, we'll never know exactly what's going on here.
So, who the
tell
F
me what
is
you
that,
think.
Man? Who the F is that? Creepy.
Cave crisis.
Holy moly,
Alex
man.
From the YouTube channel Underground Explorers is invited to explore a cave on his friend's ranch in Texas. But the cave is partially submerged in water, making it very difficult to enter and explore. Now, I'm going to go ahead and say that this video is not exactly anything paranormal, but it is very scary and 100% real. It's especially
check
scary
it out.
If you're even the slightest bit claustrophobic. Now, in accordance with YouTube guidelines, I want
not
to
really.
Stress,
are
no
you?
One was seriously injured in this video. The following footage was recorded by a professional cave diver. Do not attempt to do this yourself.
I won't. Don't
right.
worry.
So, Alex is joined by a few of his friends as they begin to explore the frightfully small cave.
All right, who's got the oxygen meter?
Right
I don't
there.
See that. Look at this. We got an oxygen meter now. So people won't be mad at me. So what all does that show? Carbon monoxide?
Carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen sulfide, and a little oxygen.
Cool.
Pretty much
awesome.
Yeah, so we got the Action Adventure twins here helping us out. As you guys are like, Matt, check the oxygen. Oh, danger levels.
Breathe
huh?
on it a little bit.
Danger. And it's waterproof?
It is, but I don't
better
think it's
be.
Gonna work too well if like the little intake
yeah,
is clogged with water.
Yeah, it's gonna be hard to keep that thing out of the water.
Alright guys, we
would you guys
out.
Do that?
The cave that's on the demolition ranch. Or off
wait,
the ranch
is
channel.
It beeping already?
Well, see, I immediately dumped it underwater.
I told you.
So, you know, I don't think this is going to give us the accurate...
Probably
read.
Not accurate.
Or the entire cave has bad air.
It might.
Get into it!
Oh. I'm not particularly... particularly claustrophobic. But this, I wouldn't go there. I wouldn't do this. Would you? Tell me in the comments if you would, or if you have done it. This is crazy, man. Imagine being trapped down there. poster, man.
As they work their way deeper and deeper into the cave, the passageway becomes smaller and more claustrophobic. Eventually, there is barely even room to breathe above the murky water. This is when the exploration goes horribly wrong.
Oh. It could only go wrong, you know? What did they expect?
I love that they're saying this is intense.
Yeah,
because
you heard that yet.
That makes me feel good, because I was scared in here, and I'm like, what if these things just come in? And they're like, oh, it's a piece of cake. Let's climb it.
Yeah. No, this is a little rough.
Yeah.
I feel a rope on my foot. Oh, so much water in my ears.
Yeah, same. Oh, man.
Water in my eyes. Snorkel would be nice right by now.
Yeah.
I got so much water in my head.
Good times.
Good
time.
What?
Yeah, no
wood pouring.
Does it really go further? Is he under? Oh, hell no, I'm not doing that. I can just barely hear right here.
So loud.
This is the waiting area.
Is he about to drown or what's going on?
Are you going, Jacob?
Oh, he just bailed.
Oh, he wants to go out of there, man. What did he see? Was that screaming? What's going on? What's going on? I have no clue what's going on.
Alex's friend and fellow cave explorer Jacob is a little further ahead in a part of the cave that is so submerged that there's barely room to breathe. As he ducks under the murky water, Jacob becomes confused and panics, breathing in a mouthful of the dirty water.
Oh.
In a terrified frenzy, he tries to back out of the cave as fast as he can, but he slams into Alex, dragging him underwater too. Luckily, the two guys make it out safely, with only a few scratches to remind them of the terrifying incident.
I'm so happy that went
good. This video once again goes to show that sometimes people, even your own friends, can be much scarier and more dangerous than anything paranormal.
Yeah.
And I don't know about you, but just watching them in that cramped little tunnel gave me the heebie-jeebies.
Yeah, got the heebie-jeebies
now,
as well, man.
You can watch this entire exciting cave exploration and many more over on the YouTube channel, Underground Explorers.
I will check it out.
Hiding under the bed. In another creepy video shared to TikTok without a source, a man is woken up in the middle of the night by a strange thumping sound coming from under his bed. What happens next is absolutely horrifying.
Oh, it's the bed monster. What?
The man looks under his bed but sees nothing that could explain
what
the mysterious
the
thumping. But then a horrific thing comes sliding out.
How is that even possible? He just looked under there. There was nothing. There wasn't space for anyone to be under there. What the F, man? Holy spatula, fork, and knife.
Out from under his bed. And the video cuts. Now, I'm in no way claiming that this video is real, but it is definitely very creepy.
Yeah,
and
it scared the shit out of me, man.
I'll leave that for you to decide.
What?
The haunted USS Salem. Seth Borden from the YouTube channel Seth and Chase, Josh from Exploring with Josh, and paranormal investigator Stephen Dillon from Haunted Nights joined together as they set out to investigate the many reports of paranormal encounters on board the historic Navy cruiser, the USS Salem. Although the USS Salem was never involved in any military combat, it was often used as an emergency relief ship and gave medical aid to horribly injured victims, both civilians and Navy crewmen. It is said that up to 400 people have died on the USS Salem throughout the years, including men, women, and children. Today, the Grant Historic Ship is preserved as a museum in Quincy, Massachusetts. Many visitors and employees claim to have seen or heard paranormal activity while on board the ship.
Yeah, why wouldn't there be a lot of spirits? And so many people died in there, you know?
The ship's caretaker, Don, explains to the group of investigators that one very active spirit on the USS Salem is that of an older sailor who they refer to as Chief.
And this is, I think, where the Chief hangs out.
You think the Chief is here?
Well, I think the Chief hangs out in here now.
Okay.
So you would say that, like...
Why would the Chief be in the chicken, yeah. Why would the Chief... Why would it... I'll try again. Why would the Chief be in the kitchen, not the chicken? He should be in the engine room, yeah? Isn't that the engineer? I don't know.
Like Chief,
I think so.
The authoritative figure.
I would say the Chief is the guardian of the ship. The Chief is the man who...
Maybe he's
who
just
is
hungry.
...concerned with people disrespecting the ship and things of that nature. Yeah. When the pandemic first started and I started working at home, I let my hair was longer than yours. I mean, it was down to like the middle of my back. And every time I came aboard, the Chief would yank my hair.
Oh, man.
Damn it.
The guys decide to do an EVP session
yanked.
To try to communicate with the ghost known as the Chief. The recorder captures some very disturbing responses.
We are
something clear as day.
Yeah,
yeah, that was clear as day. Usually those things, you know, when you hear something, it just says rah, 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 some gibberish, yeah? But that was clear.
Dude.
We are.
Oh.
Bennett, we are.
Oh my
crazy
God,
as shit ever.
What is that last word? So wild.
It's two syllables.
Yeah.
That's wild, man.
We are alive. We are something.
Do we try? Do we just sit there and try it one more time?
Yeah.
We.
Because now we've heard them. We can tell them that we can hear you. You know what I mean?
Okay. Yeah.
It's
we'll
right there.
Back. All right. I'm gonna do it again. We heard you say we are something. We can't understand you.
Say it again.
Can you repeat yourself? We are what?
Can the Chief come down here and talk to us?
Chief, if you're here watching us, can you tell us your name?
Oh, that give me the chills.
Oh my God, I did it again.
And they're multiplying.
Well, I don't even want to film, like, if this is f***ed. Every question.
What?
Oh my God.
No, bro, I don't want to film.
What is generating those streams? Not those screams. You can hear what they are saying, and we don't hear anything with our ears. But in this, you just hear some awful screaming, man. What?
Oh my God.
The Chief is angry.
Oh, we got some...
Yeah?
Yeah, I got
or in agony.
I'm never one to like show off evidence to like people until like we leave, but like I just want to show you this.
Yeah, we want like the raw reaction to this.
Yeah, we've heard that before.
You've heard them get pissed off like this before?
The group believes that they might have made contact
like
with the entity known as the Chief. And it seems that they have really pissed him off. Next, they investigate the mess hall, a large room that is said to be where the Chief appears the most. Using an Ovilus device and an EVP recorder, the group questions the spirits that haunt the ship. And this is when things get downright creepy.
Who's following us here? And why are you screaming?
Helpless.
Helpless. They're helpless.
Oh, we're helpless.
That's way worse. Sometimes.
Something yanked his hair now?
I literally just felt my hair get flipped.
He said every time he came out here, you gotta...
Can we see it again?
My hair was longer than yours.
Hopefully we can see it, no? With the slow motion or something.
I mean, it was down to like the middle of my back. And every time I came aboard, the Chief would yank my hair.
If you saw it on camera, but I felt it. Holy
I hope we see it on camera.
Yeah, we'll mind you.
Oh, good point. Flashlights on.
Look at his hair.
Helpless.
Look at his hair.
Helpless. They're helpless. Oh, we're helpless.
What?
Just like what happened to the ship's caretaker, Don, something seems to touch Seth's hair.
Yeah.
But that's not all they captured. Now, before this next clip, it should be mentioned that the ghost of a young girl and her mother are also said to haunt the USS Salem.
That's crazy, man.
When the explorers review their footage, it seems like they might have encountered one of these spirits without even knowing.
Maybe we should...
Alice?
A woman's name, right after we heard a woman's voice.
Did you see it? If you watch closely, you can see a figure that looks like a girl in a long skirt walking in the background.
Alice.
Really?
Alice?
A woman's name, right after we heard a woman's voice.
Alice?
A woman's name, right after we heard a woman's voice.
I see something white there, but...
So did the group make contact with the chief? Or, well, did the chief make contact with Seth? And is this
sure
the ghost
did.
Of one of the women who haunt the ship?
Maybe.
I leave it up to you to decide.
Thank you.
You can watch this entire investigation over on the YouTube channels, Seth and Chase, Exploring with Josh,
that was wild, man.
The waiting room. Trixie Joy Velasco from Davao, Philippines, is in the hospital giving birth to her daughter, while her fiancé, Dave, is waiting in an empty hospital ward nearby. While waiting, he sees something that sends a chill down his spine.
Oh, there's a feet.
What?
There are feet. But there's no one there.
There's no one in the room, but as Dave looks under the bed, two legs can be seen standing at the other side of the room.
Holy.
He looks up. And again,
I don't know
there's
what.
No one there.
Holy crap, balls.
He is pretty freaked out. So did he accidentally capture evidence of the paranormal? Or just who or what do these legs belong to?
What the heck?
Playtime?
Could it be some prosthetics, you know? That doesn't come over the beds, you know, when you look from above? Why is he looking under the bed in the first place?
Is over.
Lorelai
Gonzalez from La Paz, Uruguay says that the 10-year-old daughter of one of her family members recorded a very creepy video while she was playing in her bedroom. The young girl is proudly showing off her brand new kitchen playset to the camera when suddenly she gets the scare of a lifetime.
Dos tenedores así. Una rosita, igual que el cuchillo mostré al principio. No sé si lo mostré al principio. Y este tenedor
look at the doll.
Amarillo. Pues tiene... Pues se me está cayendo todo. Perdón, se me está cayendo todo. Dos cuchillos amarillos iguales.
I don't have time looking at the doll. I want to see what she is showing us. You know? A cute kid.
Tengo esta tacita, rosita, y esta tacita.
What?
Como fucsia. Huevo. ¿Sí?
What? What?
The creepy little doll seems to push.
If that is her parents pulling a prank on her, that's just evil. They wouldn't do that. What is going on?
Over a plastic cup. The girl is a little confused but shrugs it off and continues showing her playset. Then the doll's arm lifts up and falls back down all on its own. The girl makes a run for it, flipping her camera and yelling for mama. According
Holy
to Lorelai,
be-Jesus.
The video was recorded years ago and the girl is now 14 years old. But she is still freaked out by this whole incident.
I understand.
They have no idea how the doll could have moved by itself. So this creepy recording remains a mystery to this day.
That's crazy, man. What?
Off the wall. 6 months ago, Reddit user AMRV5 moved into an old apartment along with her two roommates. Since then, posters, pictures, and basically anything they hang on their walls will frequently just fall to the floor for unknown reasons. This has happened so often that the three roommates are starting to get a bit freaked out. One night, Reddit user AMRV5 is all alone in her apartment. Something happens that is truly bizarre.
What the f***?
A picture frame on the wall rocks back and forth on its own. Then the desk chair slowly moves to face her.
Yeah.
The video cuts out there because Reddit user AMR...
Oh, imagine. That ghost is just sitting in that chair, moving the frame, and then... turning the chair to look at her. I am here. You don't see me, but I'm here. Huh? Oh. That's creepy, man. You evil-ass spirit.
MRV5 is so terrified that she hurries off to the kitchen to wait for her roommates to come home. Now, after posting her video to Reddit, shocked viewers ask if there might be a more logical explanation. For example, maybe the air vent above the picture is simply causing a draft. So AMRV5 explains that her thermostat is set to turn the heat on at around 4 p.m. every day, and that this could possibly cause an air current. So the next day, just before 4 p.m., she grabs her phone and records the vent.
This is our vent test. We have about a minute until the heat's supposed to cycle on. And we're going to see if that does anything to move the picture frame.
Supposed to look at the picture or the vent. What? I'm out of here. He doesn't want to stay in there. I got goosebumps. Did someone just stomp up the stairs? Picture's down. Was it just her, you know, stomping?
He did not come on yet.
While waiting for the heat to come on, there's a loud bang at the door. When AMRV5 goes to check it out, she finds that a shoe has fallen down the steps. But then, another loud bang, this time from inside her apartment.
It was her stomping.
She hurries back in and finds that the picture frame has fallen completely off the wall. So what do you think is going on
That's
here?
That's weird, man.
Could Reddit user AMRV5's apartment actually be haunted? I leave it up to you to decide.
That's creepy,
man. Bad vibes. Popular Czech ghost hunter Danny Threeman from the YouTube channel TV Twix and his friend Dominic set out to investigate an old abandoned laboratory in the Czech Republic.
TV Twix. You guys, I think this is still around. Remember those chocolate bars, Twix? I don't know which countries you get it, but I'm in Denmark and here we still get Twix. And I think it's in all of Europe. You get it in the Americas and in Great Britain. I don't know. If you don't, you have to order it from here. They are good.
Public. The building is a source of controversy and tragedy as unsuspecting employees of the laboratory were forced to undergo horrible experiments to test and study dangerous chemicals. In some cases, these chemicals were fatal. Now, years later, locals claim that the spirit of one of these employees still haunts the building, still afraid, and still angry. It's around 4 a.m. when Danny and Dominic find a room with a single bed frame, possibly a bed that belonged to one of the lab employees. They activate their REM pod device and quickly realize that something is not quite right.
Já to zkusím položit na tu postel, víš co? Kámo, čekuj, ta postel vibruje, kde byl. Je to vidět? Ona se hejbe, kámo. Kámo, ten přístroj se úplně zbláznil.
What?
A ono, kámo, vibruje celý ten rošt s tím přístrojem.
Yes. Why is it vibrating like that?
Kámo, děláš
kámo,
si
prdel. Kámo, ta postel se hejbla. Nejvíc je to tam zároveň. Ty
pípo.
To bylo nemé rovně, že jo?
Kámo, ona šla ke mně, vole.
Kámo.
Kámo. Ty krávo, OK, děkujem za znamení. Takže víme, že jsi tady s náma. Máme odejít z této místnosti pryč a nechat ti tvůj klid?
Yes, please.
Ano, zkus se nám znovu projevit.
It doesn't want them to leave. Or maybe it does. I take it back.
Kraut, já šprtl. OK, děkujeme za znamení. My tedy tuto místnost opustíme. Necháme tě tady v klidu, nebudeme se ptát na další dotazy. Nevíme, kámo, co se tomu dotyčnému stalo, proč je tady. A jdeme odsaď o prdele, kámo.
Aha.
Kámo, to si děláš prdele, vole.
Kámo.
To šlo po mně, kde byl, kámo.
Bed is chasing him.
The bed frame seems to vibrate, triggering the REM pod device. Then the bed suddenly moves toward Danny. The two investigators stay calm, but when the bed aggressively slides across the room,
that's scary, man.
They just get out of there.
Skedaddle.
After gathering their courage, they decide to investigate the building's laboratory. This lab was the site of many horrible experiments and tests that were conducted on the building's employees. Danny starts to ask questions.
How irresponsible is that, leaving chemicals, laboratory chemicals around, still?
Tests that were conducted on the building's employees. Danny starts to ask questions to try to get a response from the paranormal presence in the building. For around 20 minutes or so, nothing much happens. But then things take a terrifying turn.
Jsi tu s námi? Je tady nějaká duše, která by se chtěla projevit na nějakým z těch přístrojů? Jsme tady jenom kvůli vám, abyste nám ukázali, že tu jste, a pak se samozřejmě zeptáme na nějaké otázky, proč tu jste. Ale jako upřímně nevím,
proč tu jste.
Už tady jsme asi 15-20 minut. Přístroje, zatím nic. Trošku jsme to tady přeorganizovali, by tady byla lepší energie, ale...
Aho.
Viděl jsi to?
Co?
Čum?
Řekně se hejbe, kde byl.
Kámo,
je to vidět na tom videu, nebo ne? Vidí.
Kámo, asi jo.
You're not alone.
Já nevím, kámo.
A čum? Já, jakoby, když, i když to jako se zkusíme jako ustabilizovat, tak stejně se to jakoby trošičku jakoby hejbe, víš? Všim se z toho? Hm. Víš?
Jako, ale víte,
could it be draft?
Kámo.
That was not the draft.
Kámo.
To byla ta židla teď?
Jo. Hej, viděli jste to lidi?
Kámo, co si to dopí... s náma hraje, vole. Proje se nám, jestli si tady dotkni se těch přístrojů, zkus něco s něčím pohnout, něco posunout. Kámo, ta židla zase, vole.
Kámo. Hej, já bych si s tím dal...
Hello?
Kámo, to radši dál, vole.
Já taky, vole.
Kámo, čekuj.
Still moving.
Já jste vidět, lidi, a ta židle se fucking klá, kde byl.
Jde to vidět,
kámo. It is visible, yeah.
To
já to přiblížím, kámo.
Yes, nebo vidět, že fakt nikdo nic s ničím neděláme. Kámo, to je nějaký, vole, nějaký loophole, nebo...
Já nechápu, jako, jak si to může takhle hrát.
Kámo, víš, to je divný, jak si ně? Že jste tady hnuli věci, ale ty přístroje nic, vole, že?
A metal chain swings back and forth by itself. A chair moves and vibrates, much like the bed frame we discovered earlier. But, did you see it? Most terrifying of all, the strange translucent figure of a woman in a dress seems to walk across the hallway.
What?
Amy Tweek's team doesn't realize what their camera has captured, and even though they're freaked out by the bizarre movement of the chair, they continue to investigate, moving to a new location
with
an absolutely
man?
Gruesome past. The incubator room. According to local legend, a man was tied up and tortured to death in the back of this room. As Danny is telling the story, things start to get weird.
Tím, že vlastně ho přivázeli, linčovali jako svině, tamhle v tom zadním inkubátoru ho prostě jenom zavřeli, jo. No, to je možná ta duše, protože když jsem o tom zrovna mluvil, jakože ho zavřeli, tak se nám to projevilo, jakože asi ano.
Ty vole. Kámo.
Kámo, ty dveře toho inkubátoru, kde byl?
I wish we knew if this was the... if we knew that this was the incubator. That this tortured man was locked inside.
Nevíte to?
Co si děláš, prdel?
Kámo, se
kámo ten hejbat. Přístroj furt jede ten rempot. Co si děláš, prdel? Kámo, co se to tady děje, kámo. Ty vole?
Co bylo?
Kámo, nevím, mně přijde, vole, že ten rempot jakoby furt zvyšoval teplotu. Vzadu mi přijde, že se hejbe kámo to lano, vole. Mohl se mi to zdá.
Kámo, jestli taky...
Možná už mám kámo fakt halucinace.
Ne, fakt kámo se hejbe asi, ale...
Myslíš? Kámo.
Ty dveře, kámo.
Spirit wants to come out.
Kámo, to si děláš prdel pryč odsaď. Kámo. Já zkusím, vole, z toho equipu ještě vyndat jeden vlastně jiný přístroj.
Kámo!
Takže jde se pohled, teď viděl jsi to?
Jo, viděl jsem to, kámo.
Shit is going on.
Na to.
A ty dveře ještě,
jdu
kámo.
Jdu vzít ten přístroj, vole.
Things are really ramping up.
Kámo,
to si děláš prdel, kámo, sám ještě životě ne...
Would you guys still be in there? I would run very fast out of there.
Nepodařilo zachytit tohle.
The TV Twix guys have had enough. The two investigators grab their equipment and just head home. So did Danny and Dominic capture proof of the paranormal?
Maybe.
Could this be the spirit of one of the employees that suffered horrible experiments here?
That
or
is so creepy, man.
Is it all just an elaborate hoax?
And so weird.
You decide. The ghost in the garage. This next creepy video was reposted to the internet without a source. Allegedly, a woman named Sarah is recording a video after she notices strange activity inside her neighbor's garage. What makes the footage so creepy is that her neighbors are not home. They're away on vacation, leaving both their home and garage completely empty. This is the video.
Got a bad light bulb. Oh! Did you see it? The shadow creep! Oh! Starting back and forth. What? Who is that man? Go in there. Let's have a look.
Oh, light flickers and something seems to quickly race back and forth inside the garage. Whatever it
then
is,
it was lurking in the end.
Peeks out at her, staring right at Sarah before quickly disappearing out of sight.
Holy
crap, man. Now, without a
crap,
source, it's impossible to know exactly what's going on here. But whatever this is, moves at a speed that's just a little too fast for a normal human being.
Yeah.
So what do you think this is?
I don't know.
Let me know. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe and turn on notifications so that you never miss a video.
Please leave a like and subscribe and put on the notification bell. Those were some creepy ass videos. Definitely freakily spookily. How? Oh. Thank you all for watching. Until next time, bye bye.